DC traffic briefly held him up, but James Comey made it to his final major TV interview of the week Thursday evening. It's getting old watching award shows where celebrities toe the Democratic Party line and offer up stale talking points. This, of course, is safe and expected and is why it happens so often. A House Democrat who represents a district along the southwest border in Texas is accusing House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi, D-Calif, of lying last month when she said Democrats restricted funding for new border barriers to see-through fencing in the omnibus spending package. President Trump will meet with German Chancellor Angela Merkel on Friday ahead of a major United Nations climate meeting in Bonn early next week. Federal investigators seized as many as 16 cell phones belonging to President Trump's personal lawyer Michael Cohen when the FBI raided his home, office and hotel room earlier this month. Former NBC Nightly News anchor Tom Brokaw has been accused by two women of sexual misconduct, according to new media reports. Ex-FBI Director James Comey denied reporting by CNN early last year, which said he briefed then-President-elect Trump on the so-called Trump dossier, with a two-page synopsis. Famed lawyer Alan Dershowitz said that comments made by President Trump on Thursday suggesting he might interfere with a Justice Department wouldn't add to Trump's legal vulnerability. Kim Jong-un entered South Korea to meet with South Korean President Moon Jae-in on Friday morning local time, marking the first time a North Korean leader has crossed the border since the Korean War ended in 1953. Trey Gowdy, RSC, disputes ex-FBI Director James Comey's definition of a leak. Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, the FBI agents who came under fire after it was revealed they exchanged text messages critical of President Trump, were disheartened after then-FBI Director James Comey was fired last year, according to a new report. President Trump is using the incoming caravan of Central American migrants heading towards the U.S. border to raise money for his re-election bid. President Trump said it would be a shame if countries that the U.S. supports were to advocate against having North America host the 2026 World Cup. Comey's interview on Thursday took place soon after a previously lost stash of text messages between the agents were sent to at least five congressional panels. Roughly one-third of the U.S. Olympians and Paralympians who competed in the recent Winter Olympic Games in South Korea will be missing out on the White House visit Friday. If there's a news development that reflects poorly on the state, you better believe national media will follow up eventually with coverage not of the story itself, but of how conservatives are supposedly exploited.